Hi, welcome back. We're going to be painting Riverfront now. This is a continuation of the Quick Landscape series, and we're going to be painting some sky and some water, some trees, and some little houses today. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start this one out a little different than what I've started out some of the others, showing you some of the different ways in which I like to approach. One of the things that I firmly believe in as an artist is sketching. I started out as a decorative painter, started out first painting, then went into decorative painting, and we use a lot of patterns. And today, I think as artists, we use way too many patterns. We're all, many of us are restricted by the patterns, and artists are slowly beginning to get away from the patterns. In the step photos, you'll see some of the detailing of a brush sketching that I do. This, and I just now, just a few seconds ago, did this. This is usually how I will start something out, is I'll brush sketch on an idea, and I love to do it with the brush. Sometimes I do it with the pencil, sometimes I do it with the brush, and get in and capture some ideas of something, the areas of roof line. Sometimes I'll define it a little bit more. You'll see that in the detailed photos, step photos of this. You'll see the actual one that I started with. I detailed a little bit more, put it in some shadows and stuff. But this gives me some line ideas, and it's nice to do it with a brush because it gets the brush loose and everything into your hand. So I like to start out with that way. So when I started this painting, this is exactly how I started it out. Then I decide, the particular technique I'm going to be using. Sometimes I will dry my sketch like this, and then I can put color lightly over it and still preserve the sketch. Now, if you need to use the pattern, if you don't want to try sketching, I highly suggest you try sketching it. Look at the step photos and sketch that's on there with the brush. You just take a brownish color, and I make up a brown color, and it's very easy to do, and you just lightly come through and sketch on your design. It's really a lot of fun. If you want to add a tree, you just kind of sketch on a tree and just move the brush around like this to put in some interest and stuff for the tree. It's really a lot of fun to do. You can even do it on a light coat of white. Sometimes I'll do it on a light coat of white, where if I want to make more tonal controls of it. But I really highly suggest that you head to that. After I do that, sometimes I will dry the sketch so I can preserve it. Here I know where I'm going to go, so I don't need to really do that, because we have a finished painting here to be looking at, to reference to. And so what I'm going to do now is just jump right into the painting technique. Now, in a lot of paintings where I have sky and water, I put on light coats of white over the surface. On this particular one, I decided not to, because I don't always do it, because I like things to change. So this time what I'm going to do is take, and my brush has some green in it from the last little landscape we did, and I'm going to take out some big old dollop of white here. Let's add some of our phthalo blue to that. We'll make a nice blue. Sometimes I like a little bit of that red violet in it if you want to head more towards those ultramarine, real light ultramarine types of blue violet colors, you can. But let's just make ourselves a nice soft blue here, and we'll make up quite a bit of it, and we'll put some extender into this. And I'm just going to start to use this brush and just real quickly go right on through here and add this right through, and I'll go right through my sketch there. I know pretty much what we're going to be doing. So, but if you have a design on and you want to preserve it, you don't want to destroy all of your design, so you can reference your pattern. Just make sure that you thin this color out. Okay, just put it on thin. Just add some extender to it, thin it out, and it'll be okay. So you won't hurt it. But I'm just going to come through and just rough through some of this, and put some of the sky and water in, varying the color a little bit with some violet here. And we'll block it in. We'll block this all in. Okay. Now, sometimes on these canvases, you'll get this, when you come in like this, you see where the paint's kind of separated a little bit from that. There. That's the kind of the plastic gesso that they used in prepping of this canvas, and on these quick landscapes and stuff, I don't worry about that. As the heritage starts to tack a little bit, it'll grab that a little better. You can get rid of always that by giving your canvas a coat of white color before you start to paint. But sometimes these canvas boards, that we use for these quick studies like this, they're I get these from an art store. But they're a lower quality one, not a super quality one. use those on quick paintings, just for practice paintings. They use, you know, seems like anymore, you know, it's not like 10 years ago where they were all high quality. They seem to be getting cheaper and cheaper and cheaper. And on my canvases, these type that I do like this, I don't sell. On the ones that I do sell, I use higher quality ones, canvases or canvas panels that I use. And then now what I'm starting to do, which I'll show you in other videos and you'll be able to find it on Global Art Supply, is I'm also creating my own canvas now, using wood panel, using the linen fabric and white primer, and with just a little bit of sealer. And it is a beautiful, beautiful, high quality, professional grade surface to paint on. And so with a lot of my paintings that I sell, I'm now, just because the quality of canvas panels and stuff, which I love to paint on, are going down, I'm now starting to use those to get a better quality to some of my work. Because I want to sell the best quality work that I can, best surfaces, and that starts with the surface. And anymore, this kind of little bleeding that comes up like this because of all of these, you know, the cheaper grade gessos and plastic gessos that they use to prep these things with are just not worth it. But it's okay here for these little practice paintings like this, you know, quick landscapes. But if you're, if you're painting these and you're going to paint these, or maybe take these up in size a little bit, paint a little more detail, get a little more work into it, I would put a little more investment into a higher quality surface than some of these lower quality, panels and stuff like that are just kind of fun. Or go to a wood panel. Wood panels are great. You can work on any of your wood panels too. They're really nice. Now what I'm going to do is come in, and there's a couple of things. We're going to have a little hill line here, one here, and then we have our sky. I can quickly sketch in the sky, or I can quickly sketch in the hill line just so I know where I'm going to go. I'm going to take kind of a yellow green over here, and I'm just going to, just with my brush like this, I'm just going to quickly just put in like the idea, and it's going to come right down in this area, maybe another little hill back here, just the idea of this hill. And I'm going to work this yellow green right into the blue like this, and let it just soften out, so I already get that nice soft edge back there. And I might come in and just tap a little more right in the little area right there like that, just to give a little variation to it. We'll add a little more black to it, change the color a little bit just as I come forward, and give the impression of another hill. Now the when you're painting quick like this, all you got to remember is that colors get lighter, they become more atmospheric, and then colors get darker as they come to the front. So any kind of dark, you can even pick up a little blue. Let's even blue that up. I used more of a blackish tone in the original, but if you wanted to blue it up a little bit more, just so that this front hill is a little bit darker than the back hill. And you can even put a little bit of yellowy green into that, but it's got to be a little bit darker than the hill here into the back, and then that will look correct. You'll get this stair-stepping back to it, was what we're looking for. Now I'll paint more atmospherics to it, and we can even drop like another little bit here, even though that'll be all covered up by trees. Sometimes I'll just let that happen, even a little browner tone or something like that. Just some different tones into your hills here is really kind of nice. Don't get too carried away, because you don't really see too much of those back there. They're just an idea, just a suggestion of those back there, okay? Now what I'm going to do is come in, and you can start your sky anyway. I'm going to look overall. My sky's pretty light, so I might want to just add a little bit more of my blues into here, into my sky here. And I just hit the palette right into my painting there. And so I might want to add just a little bit of the more of my blues here and there, lightly into the sky back here, just to put a little more color contrast into the sky, so it's a little bit more blue. And that's what happens in nature. The sky that's right above you is the bluest, and then the sky gets lighter and more atmospheric as it goes to the sides. And look at that sometime. It is deep, deep blue above you, where the atmosphere is the thinnest, and then it is lighter as it gets to the side. We learned all of that in physics. I studied 4 years of college physics, and we learned all about lights and how they and they work with all different kinds of different situations, and it was really kind of fun. I never thought I'd be using it as a, all that knowledge as an artist, but it, you know, now I do. So now I have this bluish kind of color up there. Sometimes I'll start the clouds with my knife, so let's do that today. Let's just put on a little bit of my cloud right in here. I'm going to really pull your eye here, and I want it to go here, and I want it to go to the back here. So I'll leave a nice cloud right here, and then I'll let the cloud, this will be our center of interest, I'll let the cloud small down and taper off as it goes from left to right here. And we'll then just pick up some of that white, and let's just streak that through. We'll get the sky done here pretty quickly. So we have houses to do today. And those take a little bit of time. Just whisper a little bit of movement into there. We can put a little bit of tapping into the clouds here so they fade away. And like always, the lightest area of the atmosphere is up along the horizon line. So here now, I'll paint in really quickly. The movement here, just very quickly, softly, right into the hill a little bit. Boom, right into the hill. We're painting the atmospherics of the light part of the horizon line right in there. You can give a little streak in here, you know, like a little feeling of some clouds, streaky clouds in there. That looks kind of nice. This cloud's a little built up right there, so let's just flatten it out just a bit. It's going to look like it's storming. If you give some kind of rays, you know, pulls away like this, that, you know, like I've shown you in the other videos, that gives your clouds motion, movement, you know, into the painting. You can take some of your purpley color here. Let's get a little purple, which is our red, violet, and blue, and a little bit of, let's get just a little bit of black, and that'll give a little more color variation right up in here and some of this. Color into that cloud. We'll wipe our brush, pick up a little bit of white, and just kind of pull through that. There, that'll give just a little bit of shadowy interest to it. You can add more into that cloud if you want. You can add more whites to it if you want. Tap in, use the corner of the brush, pick up some nice thicker white, use the corner of the brush, tap in a little more color, a little more movement. But I'm going to keep it fairly simple because I got a lot going on in here today, so I want to keep that fairly simple. And let's just drop right down in here into the water, and let's just add some of that right down in the water. Sometimes I work the water separate, sometimes I do it all at once. We just want to move some movement into that. We'll grab a little bit, and we'll streak a little bit of our other blues into that. We don't need to have an accurate reflection of the sky into the water by any manner or means. Just, you know, the same type of feeling of movement of clouds and sky. That's all we really need to get us going in that. Now, let's look at, there's a couple of ways in which you can go about, you know, painting, you know, the objects here. One is you can start in here on your houses, and the other is work. You can start in here on some of your ground and stuff like that, which I like to put in. And so you can even start the ground like this area in here before you do the cloud. It doesn't really make a difference. And I did that on the step photos. I did the ground before I did the clouds. But or you can come back, you know, like I say so many times, you can come back and work the clouds again. This isn't a process of do this, do this, do this, do this. The artist puts on what they need to see. And as a decorative painter for almost, you know, 25 years and an artist for over 30 years, the decorative painting, we tend to put in, okay, step one, step two, step three, step four. Follow, 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 follow. And everyone gets very regimented in that. And don't do that. You know, you put in what you need. And, you know, when we're following this, which is an alla prima painting, relax, because you can put clouds in later. You can put clouds in now. You can put ground in later. You can put ground in now. There's no set order. I put in what I need to see at that particular time. And I'll vary those techniques from painting to painting to get different looks, okay? So don't try to remember exactly every single step. And don't get caught up in these steps because that'll make it your painting very stiff. What the goal of these paintings are is to get you to work very fast, run through the concepts of a landscape very quickly so that you become more casual in your painting. And you run through these concepts over and over and over again, and then they're part of you, okay? So we're going to make a green come forward here, which means if we want it to come forward, it either has to be darker or brighter. So, and what I'm going to do in this one is both. I'm going to make it a brighter, lighter, and darker. I'm going to put more contrast into it. But I'm going to start out with just a nice, general, kind of a bright green here. Let's go more of a yellow green. You can grab some of your blues and stuff like that from the sky. Let's just grab this green. Let's do a little Hansa and black. You can add a little blue to it, even grab some of your sky. Matter of fact, just take some of this right over here like this. Just toss it in there. Get a nice little variation. Find a pretty little green. And it's just to base it in here. It's just to base it in so you can see it. I want to see the green hill that I'm going to work with right there. I want to see that. I want to see the end of the green in here. I want to get some green back in here. And I want to toss this in here. This will give me a good visual perspective here, you know, of where I'm going to go with this painting. You know, lock off, get rid of some of those whites. I'm going to be doing some white houses there, so leaving them kind of white right now is not a bad thing. But that just gives me some color in there, and you can see where I'm going to go there with my painting quite quickly. Now you can come back and if you need to adjust your hills or if you want to come up and work some more in, or even take a little bit of this and toss it up into there, you can go back and you know, work some of those areas here. Work some of these greens, which is what I always suggest to people when they're doing grounds. Work them right into the houses as well. Try not to, you know, we can come in here and work a little bit and get rid of what we call the holidays. Those are the white areas of the canvas. So we can just turn around and come in here and work those areas in there, getting rid of some of those little holidays, which are, you know, good things to start getting rid of right now, okay? So you can do that. Now, the next thing I like to do is you can use a small brush, and you can use a variety of small brushes. You know, you can use like a 4-flat or a 6-flat, and this is an older 6-flat. It's all split up and everything like that. I always tell some of my floral painters, boy, when some of those, you know, those flats, you know, after you've gone through, and this one's done probably 30 paintings, you know, as it gets around that thing, it's, you know, it's losing its chisel. Its chisel's still there. It's just flared out a little bit because the paint, this brush hasn't been cleaned very well all its life. But when that does happen to it, it still makes beautiful painting brushes for landscapes and casual florals. So don't ever get rid of those because there's techniques you can use with those. But let's grab into some black right into this. Let's darken this down. Let's get a little blue into this and a little black into this. Let's darken this right on down pretty good here. And let's come in and let's set some areas of contrast, which is going to be right in here by the house. And we'll come right up by the house here. We'll put a little bit of an angle to the ground here. And then we'll come right across the front here like this. And I'm just going to sketch in. As a matter of fact, we can go pretty much up here towards the horizon line. We'll just lighten that ever so much, just a little bit here. And so we'll keep that dark right in here. Nice dark contrast. This really helps this part of the house and everything here come forward. We'll put a little bit of that here over onto the other side, and I need to get a little bit of that green over there. Forgot that right there. So we'll put a little bit of this over to this side here and run it. And remember, like I say in the other landscapes, don't always go side to side. Run it back and forth and down because you're pulling the viewer's eye this way. So you're running it a multitude of directions here. You don't want to just run it one way. Don't get caught in the habit of running your color just always side to side to side to side to side like that. You'll cut your painting right in half. Run your brush in many directions like this. Run your brush in many directions. Keep that movement to it. Let's come over to the other side here. We'll put a little bit. This will angle back slightly. We'll put it here. And I don't worry about all on these quick little paintings. I do a lot of what I call 1, 2, and 3 point perspective lectures and drawing lectures, and I don't worry about the perspective on these small little guys too much here. I mean, we know perspective. I know perspective very, very well and how to present it into paintings and stuff. But, you know, I'm a firm believer in some of the philosophies of the Impressionist, of relaxing those perspective lines to create more interest within the painting. So I like to do that. So, and I'll do that very regularly here to relax a line. So now we have some shadow in there. We could have probably a little bit more right in here. This is the main interest area of the painting where I want to draw the viewer, is right up in here. So I'm going to keep those colors just nice and dark in there. We'll work a few light little bushes and stuff. But I want to keep those nice and dark and some brushwork and stuff in there. Now that also tells me now I can start up some of my trees. I can come up into the top and start my trees. Now I've shown you trees with a knife. You can put the trees on here with a knife, very easy. I've showed you trees with the little bristle brush. I've showed you trees in the, I think we did it in the inlet. We did trees with our little flat like this, and I'm going to do trees like this again. And this time I'm going to let the trees just be very, very simple. These trees are very simple, just a few colors into them, and just real wispy here, and very, very impressionistic, and we'll put a little bit more work into the house. And the houses are kind of a little difficult things to paint, especially when they're going to come into contrast with a bunch of trees that can have a lot of interest in it pretty easy. So we're going to keep our trees a little bit simplistic. Let's take some of our, we have our green here. And I want to put some blue into this as well. So we're going to change a couple of greens into our trees. I want to make a soft, let's look for a soft gray green that I can use as a nice base for my trees. And that's a pretty green that's right about there like that. Not too bad. Maybe a bit brighter into the yellow. There like that. That's a pretty green. So it has a little blue in it. There's a little black, a little yellow, little white. I'm going to load that into my brush here like this. I'm going to come just to right about in this area here. Now I'm going to go up above the house up here. I'm going to use the corners of this little brush here like this, and I'm going to roll the brush back and forth like this, like I did in the inlet, to make the shape of this tree here and lighten it up. We'll tap into a little more color, and as we get down by this hill, we'll start to make it a little bit heavier. So I like to have a nice heavy coat of it right in front of that hill, so we'll get a good visual plane line there. We'll divide those two planes up, the two visual planes. We'll tap this up a little lighter up there, maybe a little more touch up there. I'm just leaving those sky holes. Up at the tip up there, we'll leave those little sky holes, which is the light coming through. And then we'll go a little heavier down through here. Here we go. And right down into this area here, we'll have another little tree coming right in here. And that got a little heavy there, so I'll go, you can push it back out with the sky here, since the sky is so nice and wet. We'll just whisper that a bit. I wanted a little more sky hole there. So we'll grab that right there. And we'll come down and make it a little heavier. Let's get a little more color. And I don't always make up tons of that color, because I'll make it up again and the color will be a little different. And that's great. You know, I have so many students for years that are like, well, how do you know you make the light color? Well, you don't always make the same color. That's what keeps your painting evolving and pretty. You know, you just need to carry the color over to some other things. Don't worry about making the precise other color. I don't. And that's so when you're looking at my painting, you're looking at all different types of colors. And if you're here painting my painting, that's how I do it, is I don't make the same color. So if you want to get that kind of interest, join me in just relaxing your technique, okay? So I put those in there. We're going to have another one here, right up over here. Make sure you cross, if you have a hill line, this one's a little high of a hill line there, but if you have one there, make sure you don't start right at that hill line. Make sure you at least cross it a little bit, and we'll put a small tree back here behind this house on this side here. Okay? Here we go, just like that. Now, you can go on and do the other trees there, or I'm just going to take just a second, and I'm going to take a brown color, which I use for my sketching here, which your brown, I'll just mix it up here again for you. Brown is red and black. That's my favorite brown right there. And then sometimes I'll add some of my Hansa yellow into that as well. And I'm going to use my smaller little brush. You could use a chisel. You could use the chisel of the small brush. You could use your round brush. The point of your round, you could use the edge of your palette knife. We've used all of those. And I'm just going to just chisel in here just a little bit of the tree here. Now, sometimes I'll add the shadows before I do that, before I do this. And sometimes I'll just go right into this, and then we'll add some shadows. I vary my technique a little bit. I don't always like to have one specific way. And the other one, I didn't have a little trunk on that one there, but I'm going to on this one today. And I'm going to put one into this, and maybe a little touch here and there, or an idea of that going through the rest of the tree. This little edges of it and stuff was kind of nice. And after I do that, I like to take a little more blue into this, and a little black and a little yellow. Make a darker green, darker blue-green color here. Any of them work. Darker little blue-green. And let's just add some touches here. Again, we don't want to go up too high with this, but right into here we'll add a few little touches of some of the shadowing color, right up there like that. And let's add a touch or two here into that. Remember trees from some of the other lessons. Trees are going clumps. Don't just tap all over the place. I paint the shadows and everything in like little clumps of the trees. And, or sometimes you'll have a tree have a light side and a dark side. But don't just tap all over. You know, there's thought to it. Like this little clump will have a little shadow to the low side. A little shadow to the low side on that one. A little shadow there on the low side of that one. Okay? Don't just tap dark around and think it's going to look like a tree. The tree is painted very specifically. And I have a wonderful DVD on trees if you want to see that, where I talk about painting the back, the midground, and the front of the tree. Okay? Now we'll just come in. Let's just mix some of these greens together here. Find another nice little green. That's pretty, because, you know, this is a quick little guy, quick little landscape. So we're going to just come right in here. These back lines of trees, we won't see too much of them there. We're just going to roll our brush here, create some atmosphere in between, some sky holes in between these areas of the trees here. Don't make them all the same height. Vary them a little bit high and low. Okay, and we'll just come down like this. Pick up some more color. As you get down around that line, they'll get a little heavier. So you just see some of the atmosphere through the tops of the trees here. Okay. And we'll come in here, right in there. We'll put a larger one. Let's come back up here by the top, up above this hill. Not as high as this one. Let's come right in here someplace. And we'll roll the brush a little bit heavier down at the bottom. Just kind of roll the brush out here. Create. I love making it with these little flats, these very casual, quick trees, just rolling that edge just to get those different edges to these trees. Works so nice. And then we'll work a little heavier color down here at the base. There we go. That's pretty nice. And again, you can come in and put some stems in now, or you can put the shadow in. These are a little bit more casual than some of the other trees I do, so I'm just going to drop some of the stems and trunks in here. A few stems and trunks. Then I'll go hit the shadow. There, just ideas of those. Here. There we go. Just little ideas. And maybe a few little trunks of it coming down here. You don't know how many trees are there, so we'll just put some in, some ideas there. tap through just a bit to break up and soften some of that. Okay. Then we'll darken. Now you can darken before you put those tree trunks on too. So when I paint more detailed trees, I do that. When I paint real quick trees, sometimes I'll just put the trunks on like I just did, and then come back and put the shadows on, because they don't carry as much color. I don't have as much dimension to them. They're not as important, so I don't work them as much. So when anything is not as important and I want it to go back, I don't put as much detail even into my technique when I'm painting it, okay? Just keep that in mind as you're painting. So I'll keep the technique even more simplistic. It still has a light, a shadow, a base, and a trunk. But we don't have to get quite as involved into it as we do with others. Let's just put in an idea of a little one right there. Sitting back behind that one. A little bit of a holiday there. White. If you see any areas of white canvas coming through, you got to get rid of them, because those will affect your painting. So we want to get rid of some of those. Even get some of these darks down in here. There we go. Variations to it, but let them come really light and airy up there at the top. And we'll add a little more variation there. Light and airy at the top. Let some of those sky holes come through in there. That adds more interest to that. Now I've got a little bit of a hill line. I'm just going to take a gray green here and bring this down just a little bit here closer. I got a little to the house right there. It's just a little bit, so it's just a little bit of color in there, and it will affect the house. Now I can also, when I start to build these, you can build these trees here very, very dark in here. This is your dark area. You can come put in your dark area back in here and really, really make this dark. And we suggest that, and this is like your center of interest line in here. When I did the original step photos, this was the first tree that I did, and watching my dark, and then I ended up coming back in and making the tree a little bit lighter as it got up here and got a little higher, which I suggest. But the big thing is, make it so you can see a little bit of your trunk, that you have more sky holes up here. It gets a little heavier and very, very dark down through here. That's the big thing. This is your contrast area. So you really want to get that contrast right down in this area, keeping it nice and nice and dark. Okay? Now, we'll come in. We'll make kind of a brownish color. You can make the brownish color again. The reds and the blacks. Even I'll cool this off a little red violet in that too. And a little bit of the blacks in there. Very nice, deep, dark color. Adding some of our yellows in there. We'll make that, we'll lighten it just a bit and really kind of brown it up a bit here. Okay, so, and then I'm going to use that color right directly here. We use my number 6. I'll use that color right directly. I'm just going to draw right across like this. Try to have it kind of parallel to the bottom of it here. And we'll pull down a bit. This will be the roof, and I'm gonna just scrub and manipulate this color a little bit. Now, in a relaxed painting, you'll just relax that line just a little bit, so it's not quite so perfect. And I have a problem with that as a painter, in that I'm left brain, and I tend to make these things really, really perfect. And I like my houses. You'll hear me say this on all of them. I like them when they're more relaxed. When I come into these details here and I paint them a little quicker, sometimes with just a big brush and just a pull stroke of a color, that's when I really like them. But I also have a nasty habit of playing with them. And that's something that you should try to avoid, is playing with them, because then those lines get really stiff and really straight and really perfect, and they're not as pretty when they're that way. So we're going to try to paint these kind of quick and relaxed. Slide your brush several times back and forth like this. Don't worry about having, perfect perspective to it. This is a casual painting. And we'll just put the little edges here of the roof lines in and get out of there. There's another little edge of one back in here that I put in I decided to sneak into the painting back there. So we might as well sneak it in and hopefully remember that that one's sitting back there. Okay. Now, as you come into this color, here's my colors here, which my browns and my greens, which make great stuff. And I'm going to take some yellows right in between here. This is all great to get these reds in there. These all make, let me see if I can grab some of this. These all make just lovely, dirty, grayed whites. This is what I'm looking for. Let's get grab some of that little blue, the sky color in there. This lovely grayed whites. And that's what I want on the house. I don't want a pure white house. I love the grays. I love to paint white houses in everything that I do because they lighten up the scene. Sometimes you put colored houses in there and they tend to get heavier. And I know I do a lot of white houses, but I like them because I feel that they make the scene lighter and airier. So I'm just going to sneak that color into that, right in there, right into this color into here, right into the side, and see, it's real dirty and mottled on my brush, and that's what I want, this dirty mottled color. And when you paint a house, like when I painted the original there, I spent more time on the house just because I play with it than anything else. So I'm going to try to paint it really quick for you today. And we'll paint the planes in just a minute, but we'll toss in some color here, get rid of our holidays there, okay? And it's mottled, so sometimes I may come over here and, you know, hit a little more brown right up underneath the eaves or something like that. Sometimes I like to draw a little bit of the darker brown and come through like that. You know, you're going to try to make the house very painterly, which means you're going to manipulate color back and forth. You may use a small brush. You're going to push stuff around, up and down, side to side, some angles, some colors. All the Prima painters will try to make it as simplistic as possible. Just, you know, state the shapes just as simplistic and easy as possible. And I'm going to come in just a little bit closer here, okay? And so you can see that nice and clearly. And so we'll put a little bit of what I did on mine in the house there is I put just a little bit of green into the roof there. You know, just a quick little stroke like that, just boom. And that breaks up the roof, the colors into the roof too. We don't want them to be, you know, always the same. And notice how I move my brush in all different kinds of directions and angles when I paint that. I may come back and restate a little more brown color, you know, in on top of that just to... Real casual there, real casual here in this, and right on this edge here, real casual, there, like that, a little bit back here, there we go. And so now the house is really mottled in here with all of these colors. And I'll step off. I'll pick up some white. Let's drop that right over here. And we'll tap through some of that white, some of these yellows here, and colors. And tap right into these and model this up onto your palette just like this, okay? And I'm going to wipe off some of that extra on my brush so I can come back in here and pick up some of this light. Just kind of tap through and pick up some of that light, but it's nice and modeled on my brush. Now, the first, since you don't know exactly how light this is going to be, the first stroke I'll take is to the one of the lightest areas of the house, which is going to be right across here, this front area here. So I'll put a little bit of paint on there and maybe pull down and manipulate it a little bit into position here. But you don't want to do it so much that you lose these little streaks and little angles and little ideas of it there. I'll come back, I want that a little lighter, so I may come back and pick up a little bit of light, and we'll just hit that again, right there like that, and just pull down and manipulate that in, work that in. You may pick up a little bit of the other original color and touch that into it, and I don't want to play with it too much, because this is where, I mean, if you're like me, you'll end up playing with it all and come back with the same color, but I do want to get some movement of some of these tones through this house like that. And so it's uneven like that. That makes it really pretty, just like that. Okay? Now we'll come over and do the same thing. But on this other side over here, we're going to make it a little bit darker here. But we'll come through, pull some color through, manipulate it a couple of different ways here. They're like that. Let's change color. Pull down. They're like that. Okay. And you may pull through a couple of different ways. You may put a little more dark here. And we'll get some of that green. I just took my finger and drug some of that green right through there. And that just breaks up and adds another little color in there. You want the house so it's going to be light so you can see it, but you don't want it to be, to jump off as just pure white here. So we'll just manipulate that just a little bit here. That'll be nice. That looks nice. Now another little lighter stroke right across the front here. There, like that. Some a la Prima painters will do that just all in one continuous stroke like that and leave that. And I wish someday that I have that kind of guts to do that. But I always seem to want to play a little bit with it. So then I'll come in and add just a little bit of shadow, manipulate that just a bit. And that makes it really kind of pretty. It gets all that modeling and stuff in there. And that makes it kind of pretty. So we built that. Let's build this other side here. Let's come down, build this, and put a little bit of a light stroke right there into the front here. We'll manipulate that a bit. Use just a chisel of your brush to remove back a little bit, and you can get your shadows back there. You may want to just touch through and just, I'm looking for modeling, looking for interest, and modeling and almost like what I call marbleizing that. And breaking those edges, you know, like I may take a little light right up there and just break up into the edge of the roof line there. That's going to keep it nice and casual as well. Or maybe you take some of this lower white and put it along the edge of the roof line there. You know, it's just real casual statements. What the painter does, the plein air painter, is they look at they make real quick statements of colors and color areas that they see, and then the viewer's eye will do the rest. So, you know, you don't need to paint anything super perfect. I'm just looking for some lights and some modeling and movement of color in there. There. And we'll just use the brush very flat here. Yeah, that looks good. Just like that. Now I'll take a little bit of the brown here. A little bit of the brown. We'll just take this right into our brush, and I'm just going to tap in the area of, like, there'll be a set of windows right there. So I'll just tap in a little bit of color. If you get too much right on that, I'm just going to make a suggestion of these windows. You get too much of those, then on these windows, then you just come back and tap some light around it, which I'm going to do anyway. But I'll just make a quick suggestion of that. We'll make a quick suggestion here into the front of that, and a quick suggestion here for the door. Here, like that, and boom, like that for the door. That's a little dark. Then what I do is I'll take some of my medium color, maybe sometimes a little white, model that into the, and just come back and tap right around the edges of those darks. Sometimes if I feel the color's too dark, I'll just lightly tap right into the center, like the center of the window there, just to lighten up the feeling of it. Sometimes I will pull a light right down along the edge of it like that and pull across like that. It gives another just a little, you know, broken line of color there. So let's pull across there, down like that, down. That right in there, just soften those down. That looks pretty good right there. And again, you could have this this house is a little warm, so if you wanted it to gray a little bit more or cool a little bit more, you could take some of your sky color down. But I think that'll dry down pretty nice for this particular house. The other house I made a little bit more yellow, so I'm just going to take my base up over here and let's just yellow it up just a bit more. And we'll come over and we'll toss some yellow into this one here. Just like that. There we go. Some yellow into there. And again, you can go up into those roof lines a little bit and, you know, relax your line a bit. Relax your line so it's not quite so perfect here. Right up in there like that. You can add some brownish type shadows. I got some brown over here, so browns or reddish brown shadows underneath the roof line here. That's kind of a nice color on that one. And down through like the edge there. And then we'll just take some of our white. We'll tap right into that, make a little bit lighter yellow. Not a bright yellow, but just a little bit lighter here. And we'll manipulate through. We'll come through, we'll hit some areas of the light like that, okay? And tap into some of our darks and pull through. And again, I'll do this just a couple of times. But you don't seem to always get it with just once. You come pretty close, but you don't always get it. But, you know, as you get more brave as an Allaprima painter, you'll be able to hit it and leave it alone. And because it's all going to work nice. But it just seems to me like when you're starting out like this and doing some of these real quick ones, you got to touch it a couple of times. You can never just leave it alone. Got to touch it a few times. Here. There we go. That's just the nature of being an artist. We want to play a little bit, but we don't want to do too much of that playing, okay? Because that makes it stiff and makes it too perfect. So we don't want to have it too perfect. Let's put a little door. Just tap into some darker color here. And let's find a little window there. Let's find a little window there. And find a little window here. I sometimes put little windows and little touches in with a little round as well because it's not quite as perfect. And I don't like it, you know, being real perfect. And the little flat will give you nice little square ones. Well, you don't always see it that square, you know, out in the, you know, when you're out looking at these types of things. Let's relax the line, tap in. I picked up a little more yellow and white. And let's just relax some of these lines a bit. Just tap into them just a bit, just to relax them. Okay. I'm going to work a little more of my red and black, darker color into the roof line here and there, just as a little more contrast here and there. There, like that. That's pretty nice. Those look pretty nice, little houses there. Let's put a soft, let's just take some of that gray, white, right back here, and let's not forget about this little guy. Boom, right there. Soften him in. Finger, just to give an impression of him sitting back there. Maybe a little dark. And a little bit more. Just sitting back there. Yeah, like that. Okay. And then we're going to start manipulating. Now, you could go down and paint water right now if you wanted to, okay, which is always a real good idea to put some of that in, especially since you got all these houses and stuff going. Or you can go over and manipulate the hill. You got to get both of those done before you go do the water and stuff. So, you know, but my colors are going to stay wet here for quite a while, so I'm going to be in good shape. I'm just going to add a little more. This is a little crooked right here, so I'm going to get a little more dark green right in there and just tap that along. But we have little bushes and stuff to add there along in some of these areas here. And I want to add those, and I've got to get the hill, and then we got to get down into the water. So the reflection of the water. Now, the reflection of the water will come down. We'll take some of our colors that are going to be right down through here. Since, you know, part of it gets lost in the lower edge here. And, you know, how much is actually lost depends on the elevation of the house, the slope of the hill, and the angle at which you're looking at that water. So it's hard sometimes to see, to guess, you know, if you're just painting something from an idea. But always it's really good to, if you're ever in doubt, just eliminate some of the ground line. So we'll eliminate some of the ground line, and we'll imagine the house starting out right about into this area. And we'll come right about that same area here, and we'll start, and we'll put the roof line in. This will be the roof line of the top of that house there, that edge there. We'll drop some of that in right in there. And as you can see, I've got this white right back behind there, which I really don't have. I have more of a green color there. So I'll have to eliminate and change that. I'll just put a little green right back behind that. you got to just kind of look in the reverse here what it is. It doesn't have to be perfect, but you just got to get a little bit of it in there. And we'll grab this dark little spot right there. We'll make sure that that's shown up in there. And we'll grab a little bit of our greenish color in there. We'll just casually suggest that that's going to be there. And we'll come down and we'll do it again right over here. And we'll just make sure here, I'm just going to casually sketch the house. I'm not going to really put the house in at all. Just casually sketch the house in color here. And we'll manipulate a little bit of our lighter colors here. A little bit, because we're going to blur these quite a bit, because this is a river. It's going to have some movement, so you don't have to, you know, like Reflection Lake that we paint in that one, where we're very, very careful. This one we don't have to be quite so careful, because we've got a movement to the water, so the water will cover a lot of our perspective lines and stuff like that that might be off a little bit, so we don't have to get a perfect reflection of anything. But it's nice to have, if you're going to have like those little doors and some ideas of some windows and stuff like that, and just take those off just a bit so they're not perfect little touches there. And those will blur up really, really nice. So unlike Reflection Lake, we don't have to be perfect here at all. And let's just come in and we'll set in just an idea here of this roof in here. We'll just, matter of fact, we won't even really put the straight lines and stuff on, maybe a little bit, but just kind of follow down. That's got to come over this way just a little bit more. There we go. Here, like that. We'll give just an idea, the idea of some yellows in there. It's a little further back, so it's going to go, you notice it's a little lower than that one, so it's got to go a little lower than that one there. Okay, we'll put a little yellow into it. You don't have to be perfect with it. Just make it real quick, because these are just quick. But you do have lines and stuff that you should try. So it should go a little closer to the edge here. It's lower than that one, so that'll reflect pretty nice there. It'll give you, super accurate, but it'll give you a pretty good idea. We'll get some of the dark. Nice dark spot is right there, just in case that shows up. And we'll just give just an idea of that. Now back behind that is going to be a lot of your green. So we got to go make up some of our greens and stuff again here. We got a little blues in those. So a little green. It's got to come back into the picture now. And we'll take some of those ideas of those greens here. And we'll just give the ideas of the trees and stuff here. Now again, this doesn't have to be perfect at all. Boom, just like that. Just get some greens and get it right into the house there as well. Leave your few little air spaces up there. That's nice. Right in between here, let's just put some greens. And let's drop those right into there. And they'll come up with their little points here. There'll be that little bit of that hill and stuff back here. A little idea of those right back here. And again, not perfect. Just manipulate that color around a little bit. And this hill line here, remove a little bit of that green. This hill line has got to go this way here like that, and we'll fuzz it a little bit, but we'll put a little bit of that coming back here, a little bit more gray here. You're just painting in reverse, but I'm painting a real quick sketch of it in reverse. I'm not trying to by any manner of means reflect perfectly like we did with Reflection Lake. Okay, that one we were more careful with. This one we don't have to be. And I'm going to take my ground, even though I'm not completely done with my ground here yet. And I'm just going to make a quick statement of that. We'll go paint some of the ground, and then we'll finish up our water and some of the other things of our water. Yeah, that's pretty good. Remember, water is what is all around it. It's what it's reflecting in. That's water. There is a little house that's in there, and when I painted the original, this is how I did it. I just eliminated it. I just eliminated it and put the trees in there. It's too much to worry about. It's not a perfect reflection. You're just going to put some darks and stuff in there and get out, because you don't need it. But you do need these nice darks, dark greens here. In fact, let me step back just a little bit more so you see more of the palette. Okay, so I do need these dark greens here. And I do need those coloring, that coloring right in here. Boom, right in there. Right back in here. And right underneath these guys right here. I need some of that. Nice dark. Just manipulate it up, right up and through there. That's all we need there so far. Okay, I need a little bit more of the yellowy green into this reflection here, so of this house, so that's closer to the original here. Reflection's a little closer to it. There we go. In coloring. And again, doesn't have to be perfect in that. Because water changes a whole bunch of things, and especially if you go putting the light blue onto the sky, you know, that changes a lot of the feeling of the water. Here we go. Big dark right here. Boom. Okay, that's a close enough for reflection for that one there. By be a little more precise, but I don't want to get like spend all of that like we did on the reflection lake. We don't need it for this one because this is going to be moving. Okay, so now what I want to do is I want to put a little bit of movement into the hill here. We're going to take some of our yellow green. Let's take some, slide right into some of our whites with our yellow greens here. Nice brighter yellow green right into some of our whites right here. And you can use the knife, you could use whatever you want. Oh, first what I should do is set in that shadow. There's a greenish shadow that's right into this area here. And I'm going to curve this just a little bit like this. This will make it look like a hill. And we'll put these shadows in underneath these trees, which is where they would be. And we'll just run our finger back and forth there a little bit. Make a quick little statement of those shadows underneath the tree here. The back side of this, and if you angle this just a little bit, this is going to make it look like a hill. Get rid of any little light spots that are up against that house so that it keeps that perspective. We don't get that little holidays of the canvas coming through. Angle that just a bit like that. That's good. That runs through, and that gives that. Now we'll just pick up this light color. We'll just slide that light color down like this and build this little streaky down feeling of this hill. And I'm going to take that same color right in here. We'll just streak in just a little bit right in there. Doesn't have to be perfect. Again, doesn't have to be a perfect capture of it, but we'll just put a little bit of that in there. And we'll pick up some more yellow color and the white. And we'll come and just pull down short strokes like this. Again, you can use the knife. I'm using the short brush like this. And that just manipulates and keeps a little movement here. And I like this little grassy movement. I like it working in and out of the shadows a bit here. I might come back and restate the shadow just a bit here and there. And that I like that type of movement that this grass sitting over this gets. Change your green a little, pick up a little more yellow, change your green a bit, come back and hit it again there like that. use some of it. If you want the ground to flatten out here, then you start using a little bit of it side to side like this, and you imagine that, and that causes that hill to flatten out. So that angle causes the hill. This angle flattens it out, just like I showed you on some of the other ones. Okay. Then we'll continue on here. And let's manipulate a little bit more greens, lighter greens, right up and through here. And again, you could use the knife. You could just sketch around like this with a small brush. Sometimes when I start a painting with a real brush sketch like that, my whole feeling stays sketchy. And so I use a small brush like this into the painting. And I like that. Just working this brush around like that. I feel, especially if in the paintings where I do the houses, I like to do this. I like to manipulate around like this, because this just adds a lot of little sparkly movement and stuff into your landscape. But quick, like you get these little granulation areas there. Leave those, you know, leave those. Be quick about your painting. Don't hang around too long or else it'll all become the same. Just move, move, move. Change colors, move, move, move. And there we go. Just move that around a bit. Okay. Change colors and move. Right? Let's just grab a little bit here into the back. Yeah. Grab a little darker green right in there. Just slide some of that in there. Get a little bit more yellow green and lighter as you come forward right in here. Give the idea of the hill there. Just kind of manipulate that around like that. And we'll drop some of that right into the water. Right in there like that. And none of this has to be perfect really for the water in here. Just get some of the ideas here. Okay, because we're going to put sky right over all of that. I'm going to take some darker green also while I'm around in this area. Take some darker green, yellow, black, maybe a touch of brown into that. And we'll cut the water's edge here. The darker color. That sometimes on this I'll actually cut the dark on the water. Sometimes I'll cut it on the ground. But I just kind of like cut a separation or a shadow separation, which is really a shadow separation of the bank. And you don't want a straight line, so we want this to undulate a little bit back and forth and get a little painterly along here. So shoot, work your brush very fast. This is why I love a small brush and small brush techniques. I love the knife. Oh, I love them all. I love them all, but I love the small brush like this, just dancing around. And I will use this. Let's just push this, you know, like I've got this a little bit straight right into here. So I'm just going to push in like this a little bit and create like a little bank undulation here. And then we'll let it come back out. Now let that just kind of just go a little different there. So it's not all exactly just a straight line. You know, maybe we'll undulate in here a little bit. So it's not quite a straight line. That'll make it nicer looking into your final painting here. We'll take a little bit of our lighter color and we'll put some of that in here. Lighter greens, different greens. Just kind of dance your brush around. I love just to dance this brush around like this, especially up and around your center of interest. There we go. Maybe a little brown. Let's get our red out here, our black out here, and some yellow. And let's get our brown and just give the idea, just drag through, just move the brush, just sketchy. Get the idea of a little path there. And I do that just very fast, sketchy, letting it short, choppy like this, letting it kind of mix with the greens there, and that'll give you some different values. Boom, just done. Just like that. Just that fast. Okay? And, you know, painting like that is really just that fast. You know, really with these landscapes, you want to paint that fast, and we want to get brushy, especially like what I'm doing now. Just get real brushy and casual and moving and manipulating those colors and let what happens happen. These are all good practice boards for bigger ones that you're going to do. You're making nice painting out of this. But, you know, really what we want to do is grab the core concepts of painting sky and land and water and get sketchy and work, and it's practice through. They're beautiful paintings, but they're practice too, you know. And so just keep that in your mind, and you'll do a nice job on them. Especially, you know, you'll get more relaxed with it, and you do a nice job. Let's take some of our gray, yellow, and some of our whites, and just kind of model those together here. And sometimes, I'll use the knife or the brush or, you know, a small edge, and we'll just take this right onto the corner here. And I'm just going to, with those greens and the yellows and the whites modeled like that, just kind of tap around and create like little bushes right here, right around. And this helps break that. We do these for a couple of reasons. It helps break the ground line of the center of interest. So you can put, you know, little flowers there if you want or something like that, you know. Might be a little too detailed for a quick painting like this, but you could certainly do that. I'll put on with one side, tap it off with the other side of the brush. And let's just put a little more casual, a little softer over here onto the other side. So just tap it a few more times. It'll mix up and soften out into those other colors. You don't want as much over here, so it appears further away. This is your center of interest area here, so you can work these a little bit in here, in this area here. Okay, just real quick, boom, boom, boom. Get those things in there. Tap in a little bit of that and get out of there. Okay, and if you want, you can back paint up with a little dark in a few areas. Back paint up here. There we go. Okay, and I'm going to add just a little more white down the edge of that. There, look at that. That all looks pretty good. Good. So now what we're going to do is I have the greens and stuff, and you might even want to put a little bit of sky. We'll go back up here where our sky, this is still wet up here. That's nice. But I'm gonna push off this over here to the side, because I'm going to do some more for the blues colors and stuff for you. If you're on your big palette, you can just go to a different area. Get back up to there. I'm just going to clean this off a little bit here so I can put some blues out for you here. And let's clean that off. We'll grab some of our regular blue here. We'll grab a little bit of our violet into that. We'll grab some of our white into that. Okay, this is our base sky color. I'm going to put that into my brush, and then I'm going to get rid of it out of the brush. Just pinch wipe it, get rid of a lot of that out of the brush, so we have the blue in there. Nice, soft, and I'm just going to pull down now, just very lightly pull down. Sometimes I use my big, soft brush, which I've sold you before. This is perfect for this, you know, to pull down the hills and blur this. And sometimes I'll just use my small one, especially if this is a smaller one here and I don't have to have real glassy look to the water. I'll just use this brush. I want a real glassy look to the water, I'll use my big brush here. And we'll just manipulate that just a bit like that and pull down through here. Pull down. Remember, water pulls down. Movement goes across here. So pull down and pull across here like this. And you can see you don't need that much. Don't need that much to say water there. Say, just blur the edge, like the edge of that house right there. Blur the edge of this right there, like those two colors coming together there. Blur that edge going out like that. That'll help you with your look of your water, okay? So just blur those. Pull down and then pull across a little bit. Now, what I'm going to do is take some lighter blue here. About the sky, it is really, you know, look up into this area of the sky find a color that's right up there about where that area of the sky is. And then we're going to just pull that across here. Pull that across the sky. As a matter of fact, I will clean off my white I just dumped on my original there. I will probably use a little bit smaller brush here. Matter of fact, let's just go to this one. This is one of my favorite ones to paint stuff like this with. It's not quite as big at the handle as a 3/4, but it's not a small one. It's just a 10. And I love to do that with this. I just set that brush down and pull a little bit of this color right across and cover up. Now see, water is really the sky, and so it's going to reflect some of the sky here right over that area there. And hi, welcome back. We're going to be painting riverfront now. This is a continuation of the quick landscape series, and we're going to be painting some sky and some water, some trees, and some little houses today. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start this one out a little different than what I've started out some of the others, showing you some of the different ways in which I like to approach. One of the things that I firmly believe in as an artist is sketching. I started out as a decorative painter, started out first painting, then went into decorative painting, and we use a lot of patterns. And today, I think as artists, we use way too many patterns. We're all, many of us are restricted by the patterns, and artists are slowly beginning to get away from the patterns. In the step photos, you'll see some of the detailing of a brush sketching that I do. This, and I just a few seconds ago, did this. This is usually how I will start something out, is I'll brush sketch on an idea, and I love to do it with the brush. Sometimes I do it with the pencil, sometimes I do it with the brush, and get it and capture some ideas of something, the areas of roof line. Sometimes I'll define it a little bit more. You'll see that in the detail photos, step photos of this. You'll see the actual one that I started with. I detailed a little bit more, put it in some shadows and stuff. But this gives me some line ideas, and it's nice to do it with a brush because it gets the brush loose and everything into your hand. So I like to start out with that way. So when I started this painting, this is exactly how I started it out. Then I decide, the particular technique I'm going to be using. Sometimes I will dry my sketch like this, and then I can put color lightly over it and still preserve the sketch. Now, if you need to use a pattern, if you don't want to try sketching, I highly suggest you try sketching it. Look at the step photos and sketch that's on there with the brush. You just take a brownish color, and I make up a brown color, and it's very easy to do, and you just lightly come through and sketch on your design. It's really a lot of fun. If you want to add a tree, you just kind of sketch on a tree and just move the brush around like this to put in some interest and stuff for the tree. It's really a lot of fun to do. You can even do it on a light coat of white. Sometimes I'll do it on a light coat of white where if I want to make more tonal controls of it. But I really highly suggest that you head to that. After I do that, sometimes I will dry the sketch so I can preserve it. Here I know where I'm going to go, so I don't need to really do that because we have a finished painting here to be looking at, to reference to. And so what I'm going to do now is just jump right into the painting technique. Now, in a lot of paintings where I have sky and water, I put on light coats of white over the surface. On this particular one, I decided not to because I don't always do it because I like things to change. So this time what I'm going to do is take in my brush has some green in it from the last little landscape we did, and I'm going to take out some big old dollop of white here. Let's add some of our phthalo blue to that. We'll make a nice blue. Sometimes I like a little bit of that red violet in it if you want to head more towards those ultramarine, real light ultramarine types of blue violet colors, you can. But let's just make ourselves a nice soft blue here, and we'll make up quite a bit of it, and we'll put some extender into this. And I'm just going to start to use this brush and just real quickly go right on through here and add this right through, and I'll go right through my sketch there. I know pretty much what we're going to be doing. So, but if you have a design on and you want to preserve it, you don't want to destroy all of your design, so you can reference your pattern. Just make sure that you thin this color out. Okay, just put it on thin. Just add some extender to it, thin it out, and it'll be okay. So you won't hurt it. But I'm just going to come through and just rough through some of this. And put some of the sky water in, varying the color a little bit. with some violet here, and we'll block it in. We'll block this all in. Okay. Now, sometimes on these canvases, you'll get this, you know, when you come in like this, you see where the paint's kind of separated a little bit from that. There, that's the kind of the plastic gesso that they used in prepping of this canvas. And on these quick landscapes and stuff, I don't worry about that. As the heritage starts to tack a little bit, it'll grab that a little better. You can get rid of always that by giving your canvas a coat of white color before you start to paint. But sometimes these canvas boards, you know, that we use for these quick studies like this, you know, I get these from an art store, but they're a lower quality one, not a, you know, super quality one. Use those on quick paintings, just for practice paintings. They use, you know, seems like anymore, you know, it's not like 10 years ago where they were all high quality. They seem to be getting cheaper and cheaper and cheaper. And on my canvases, and these type that I do like this, I don't sell. On the ones that I do sell, I use higher quality ones, canvases or canvas panels that I use. And then now what I'm starting to do, which I'll show you in other videos and you'll be able to find it on Global Art Supply, is I'm also creating my own canvas now, using wood panel, using the linen fabric and white primer, and with just a little bit of cedar. And it is a beautiful, beautiful, high quality professional grade surface to paint on. And so with a lot of my paintings that I sell, I'm now, just because the quality of canvas panels and stuff, which I love to paint on, are going down, I'm now starting to use those to get a better quality to some of my work, because I want to sell the best quality work that I can, best surfaces, and that starts with the surface. And anymore, this kind of little bleeding that comes up like this because of all of these, you know, the cheaper grade gessos and plastic gessos that they use to prep these things with are just not just not worth it. But it's okay here for these little practice paintings like this, you know, quick landscapes. But if you're, if you're painting these and you're going to paint these, or maybe take these up in size a little bit, paint a little more detail, get a little more work into it, I would put a little more investment into a higher quality surface than some of these lower quality you know, panels and stuff like that are just kind of fun. Or go to a wood panel. Wood panels are great. You can work on any of your wood panels too. They're really nice. Now what I'm going to do is come in, and there's a couple of things. We're going to have a little hill line here, one here, and then we have our sky. I can quickly sketch in the sky, or I can quickly sketch in the hill line just so I know where I'm going to go. I'm going to take kind of a yellow green over here, and I'm just going to, just with my brush like this, I'm just going to quickly just put in like the idea, and it's going to come right down in this area, maybe another little hill back here, just the idea of this hill. And I'm going to work this yellow green right into the blue like this, and let it just soften out, so I already get that nice soft edge back there. And I might come in and just tap a little more right in the little area right there like that, just to give a little variation to it. We'll add a little more black to it, change the color a little bit just as I come forward, and give the impression of another hill.